Hey church, this is day three of our mini church series that we're doing. Happy Friday to you. I'm so excited to get to hear the word, to worship with you again, to get to pray with each other. I've been enjoying actually getting to be at home with my family while we worship together. I encourage you, get your family in your living room, around your smart TVs, around your laptops, around your tablets. Let's worship God together. Let's build ourselves up with the word so we can continue to be the church strong. Enjoy the service.
Father God, we just thank you so much for today. God, we just pray that you would use this service, this time together as we gather, even in our separate homes. God, we pray for our country, for this nation, and for those who are feeling sick or ill. God, we just pray for guidance and direction for those who are in charge, for those who are in leadership positions. God, would you be with all those on the medical field front? God, would you give them grace, patience, mercy, and health in all of this? God, we pray that you would use this sermon today and this message and worship time for your glory. In your name we pray. Amen.
You mean? Hey guys, I'm Leah, and I am so excited to talk with you today. I have had a few things just kind of like rolling around my head in these last few months, and one thing that has been recurring throughout my life is just between the promise and the promised land. And I think we all kind of have this like wonderful version of the promised land for our lives in our heads. But I just want to tell you a story. So the story of Joshua, so it's actually, if you come into Joshua 21, so this is the very end when they enter the promised land. This is what it says right at the end in the Message version, Joshua 21, 43 through 45. It says, "And so God gave Israel the entire land that he had solemnly vowed to give their ancestors. They took possession of it and made themselves at home in it. And God gave them rest on all sides. And he had also solemnly vowed to their ancestors. Not a single one of their enemies was able to stand up to them. God handed over all their enemies to them. And not one word failed from all the good words God spoke to the house of Israel. Everything came out right." So I think all of us can relate to between kind of that awkward waiting in between when God gives you a promise and the promised land. So I'm using air quotes because, I mean, land of milk and honey is not for everybody, but I like to think about this as our calling or our purpose. And the wonderful thing about God is throughout the Bible, there are amazing promises, promises for health, for provision, for even for freedom, like where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom. That's one of the promises of his presence. And so I just want to address that when we have a promise from God, one of the main things that we need to make sure that we're doing is believe it. So I think the issue between for a lot of people is whether or not they believe the words that God says. And for me, I think a lot of that has to do with whether or not I know him. So if a stranger were to come up to me and say, "Hey Leah, I just think you're really cool." That'd be weird if they knew my name. "I think you're really cool. I think you're gonna do great things." That wouldn't mean as much to me as if someone I really loved and respected and trusted said, "Hey Leah, I think you're really cool. You're gonna do great things." And so first things that I wanna address is the promise that God gives you, because everyone, every single person that hears this has a purpose for their life, every single one. And part of that is the promise that God has given you. And so first of all, I just want you to know that you can believe him. You can believe the words that he speaks. And a lot of this is just built through trust. And I kind of like was thinking about what I was gonna say today, and the five love languages also relate to how we give love and how we receive love. So there's touch, there's time, there's service, there's gifts, and there's words of affirmation. And so all of these things, I honestly believe that we can give love and receive love from God in these ways. In time, just by taking time to be with him. In touch, by making sure that you're in his presence. By service, serving God in ways that, I mean, serving God also is in serving others. In gifts, for me, that would be like a sacrifice of praise. If there was something, and even tithe and offering, and words of affirmation to me is worship. And so all of these things kind of blend together, but getting to know the person who's giving you the promise is gonna help you believe it. And this is where it gets messy, is the in-between. So right in the process. So there's promise, there's process, and there's promised land. And the process is where a lot of people lose their cool, lose their patience, and lose their faith. And a lot of it has to do with just whether or not you are keeping that belief in front of you. So I think we know the children of Israel traveled the wilderness for 40 years. So this is between the promise and the promised land. And a lot of this 40-year time span was just because they just didn't believe it. And so I want to encourage you, the words that God speaks to you, you can believe. And that's going to get you through kind of the awkward in-between. I think sometimes we just get bored and we want to jump ship. Like, "God, I know you told me I'm gonna do this, but to be honest with you, I just don't see anything happening." I don't think that is a mentality that's going to help us get to the promised land. One thing that I really, really love is like, have you guys ever watched, actually, you can't answer me. So there's this movie called Road to El Dorado, and it's one of my favorite movies because I think it's hysterical, and it was the first DVD we owned. And Miguel and Tulio are these two con men, actually, but they get a treasure map. And to me, the treasure map is the promise. Do you believe that there's treasure according to this map? And then there's the road to El Dorado, which they're traveling and they're seeing all of these things. And then they enter El Dorado, which like this city, this beautiful city of gold. And I'm getting to this point in the promised land. I don't know why I'm doing this, but the promised land, where I honestly believe these are things that only God can do in your life. The one thing that we can do is remain faithful through it all. We can be good at waiting. We can be good at being faithful and showing up when God asks us to. But the promised land, that's gonna be God. For the Israelites, if you think about all of the things, all of the ways that they could have been defeated by the people that lived in the promised land, and still God showed up for them and made it happen. And I just want to encourage you, there are things in all of our lives that God is asking us to do, and sometimes we just fail because we're not faithful. We don't just show up, and we don't just believe that God is who he says he is. And I think sometimes it's not always a lack of faith. Sometimes it's just a lack of perseverance. And so for those of you who maybe have let disappointment color your life, or for those of you who've maybe let hopelessness in, I'm just going to refer to the words that Rob spoke a couple days ago and that Alex spoke. Like, let's anchor ourselves in hope, and let's abide in the vine, because he's going to provide. And something that I really, really love is throughout the Bible, it says that God is faithful to fulfill every word. And in Isaiah, it says that he'll watch over his words until they come to pass. And so I just want to encourage you. Let's first of all believe the promise that God says. Let's be faithful in the in-between, kind of the messy part where we can get bored or distracted, or even just fall into that level of unbelief, or that section of unbelief. And let's just make sure that when we get to the promised land, and these are many promised lands all over. This is not like the end game of our life. But when we get to the promised land of a fulfilled promise or a fulfilled gift, for some people that's marriage, for some people that's a baby, for some people that's a job, for all of these things, let's make sure and let's give God the honor, because really these are the things that only God can do in our life. And so I just want to encourage you in this season. We're kind of in the middle messy part. God has promised health, and it says that if we humble ourselves before him and we pray, he will heal our land. So let's humble ourselves before him. Let's pray, and let's be faithful to do what God has asked us to do in every season. So I'm just going to pray, and we're going to close. Father, we love you. God, I'm so thankful for your words that are true through and through. God, and I thank you, Lord, that in every season, your word, it reigns supreme. And so we just ask, God, that first of all, you reveal those promises to us, God, that maybe some people are really, really desperately seeking. Father, for even just that in between season, God, I believe that you are faithful. And so we are going to offer ourselves as faithful as well. And so I just thank you, God, that we are going to see the other side of not just this season for our nation, but God, even for our lives, for people who have been believing for things for years and for seasons, God, I believe that you are going to make those come to pass in your will. In Jesus' name, amen.